Welcome to ChemShow. In this video, I am going to discuss with you state function and path function. That is, what do you mean by state function? A state function is a property of a system whose value depends upon the state of a system only. It is that value, the value of the pressure, volume, temperature, internal energy, enthalpy and entropy is depending upon the state of that system. It is not depending upon the path. That is, a physical quantity is said to be a state function. The change in its value during a process depends only upon the initial and final state of the system. It does not depend upon the path. It is a state function is a property of a system whose value depends upon the state of the system only and does not depend upon the path. That is a state function. It is a physical quantity is said to be a state function. If the change in its value during a process depends only upon the initial and final states of the system. And it does not depend upon the path. It does not depend upon the path by which the change has been brought about. There's examples for these state function is pressure, volume, temperature, internal energy, U, H means enthalpy, entropy, S. Path function. Path function means a property of a system which depends upon the path. Thus, which depends upon the path followed in attaining its state is called a path function. That is, it is depending upon the path. Example for the path function is heat, work. Examples for the path function is heat and work. Let us differentiate state function and path function. The state function is independent of the path. It depends upon the final and initial state of the system. Independent is state function is independent of the path and it depends upon the initial and final states of a system. Now next, what is a path function? Path function, it depends upon the path. It's a property that depends upon the path. It is examples for state function are pressure, volume, temperature, internal energy. His examples are pressure, volume, temperature. U means internal energy. H means enthalpy. And last, entropy, that is S. These are the state function. Now next example for path function is work and heat. Okay. To understand this, let us consider one example.
Let's consider this diagram. P V. P means pressure, V volume. This is A, B. These are two states. Part 1, part 2. The coordinates are considered as pressure and volume on which the energy of the system depends.
Suppose if we are considering an internal energy change, that is delta U, change in internal energy. Here we can see state A and state B. Suppose by changing the condition, the system from B changes to state A, either through path 1 or path 2. But we have to notice that the value of delta U, the value of delta U will be equal in magnitude, or value of delta U will be same, that is change in internal energy will be same if the changes takes place through either path 1 or either path 2. That is, if the changes takes place either through path 1 or path 2, the value of delta U will be equal in magnitude. This means that change in internal energy during a process depends only upon the initial and final states of the system, and it does not depend upon the path, and it does not depend upon the path by which the change is brought about. That is, we can write like this: delta U is equal to UB minus UA. This function depends only on its initial and final states of the system. It does not depend upon the path. Let us discuss the path function. We are considering PV graph. These are two paths, path 1, path 2. It is example of path function is work, heat, etc. Let us consider the work done. Suppose if we are considering the work, work is a path function. Here we can see two states, A and B. Suppose by changing the condition, the system from B changes to A, either through path 1 or 2. That is, the value of work will not be equal in magnitude, will not be same if the changes takes place through 1 or 2. That is, this work depends upon the path. It does not depend upon the initial and final states. Work is depending upon the path. That is, path function is the function which depends upon the path of the system. Now, second point. These are exact differential. These are exact differential. You can write like this: du, dh. This internal energy and enthalpy is the example for the state function. Exact differentials can be integrated between the appropriate limits. We can integrate between appropriate limits. That is, du is equal to U2 minus U1 or UB minus UA. UA, UB. That is, exact differentials can be integrated between appropriate limits. This cannot be done in the case of inexact differential. That is, this path function. These are inexact differential. Can write dq dw. Path function cannot be integrated between appropriate limits. We cannot integrate between appropriate limits. Okay. That is, this path function need multiple integrals and limits of integration in order to integrate. These are the difference between state function and path function. Okay.